Hi everyone, welcome to episode one of Back to Nostalgia, the throwback show for everyone. Today's guest really needs no introduction, but I'll give her one anyway. It's Georgina Hagen. Hello.
Hello.
How
Thank you
are
very much.
you?
I'm very well, thank you. How are you?
I'm great, thank you. I've been looking forward to this quite a lot.
Oh, bless you. I've been really looking forward to it too, to be honest.
The 13-year-old me is screaming right now. So how have you been? I've not
Yeah,
seen you on
really
screen
good.
for years, so I know you've been like doing the West, like doing productions on stage and stuff.
Yeah. I have. I know. I haven't really actually haven't done any telly since Britannia High. So I've
Wow.
been taking a bit of a break from the screen and been doing, yeah, stage work.
Wow. So you've been in like Starlight Express and that
Yeah,
kind of thing. So you've been a busy bee.
I have. I've been very busy. Busy bee.
Okay. Of course, thank you for joining me today. It's an
Thank
absolute
you for
honor.
having me.
I want to go back to the very beginning of your career. Was musical theatre something you've always wanted to do, like
Yes.
acting and singing?
Yes, it has been because both of my parents are in the industry.
Okay.
So I grew up wanting to be like them,
Oh, wow.
basically. So yeah, it was always something that I knew I wanted to do and started doing from a very young age. Yeah, I haven't really stopped.
What sort of dance school did you go to? Was it like a college that you went to, or
So I went to a theatre school called Sylvia Young's,
okay,
which
yeah.
is you do 3 days a week of like academia and then 2 days a week of dancing, singing and acting.
I've heard of Sylvia Young before. I think it's where a lot of people have first started that we
Yeah,
know, like you know
it's
today.
brilliant.
I think Emma Bunton was there as
She
well.
did, yeah, she was.
I had a previous guest. I don't know if you remember Tisha Monique from the
Yeah.
411. She
Yeah.
went started at Sylvia Young as well.
Yeah, a lot of people did. Tom Fletcher from McFly,
Wow.
Amy Winehouse,
Oh, I didn't know that actually.
gosh, Billy Piper, loads of people.
Wow.
I say loads of people. Rita Ora. Rita Ora was in my class.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
That's quite cool.
Yeah, really cool actually. And funnily enough, two other cast members of Britannia High also went to Sylvia Young.
Oh, I'm going to try and guess. I would say Matthew James Thomas is one of them. And maybe, is it? I'm going to say Sapphire. Oh, wow.
Well done. That's
I
brilliant.
didn't Google that. That was literally a guess. Like,
I'm
wow.
very impressed. It
Thank
has to
you.
be said.
Okay, so obviously we know you as Lauren in Britannia High,
Yeah.
but way before that, you starred in another show on CBBC called Tracy Beaker,
I
and
did.
you played Rebecca.
I did.
But you did like called being called Bex. I remember.
Not Becky or Bex, not Rebs or Rebby,
What
Rebecca.
was that like being on the
Oh,
show?
it was amazing. So, funnily enough, it wasn't the first time I auditioned for it to play another part a few years prior to when I actually got it. And I loved the book. I loved Jacqueline Wilson so much. And I watched Trace. I watched like the very first couple of seasons
Yeah.
avidly as
Same.
a child. So when I got asked to be part of the series, I thought that all of my Christmases and birthdays are coming up. It was so much fun. It was so much fun. Like getting to film it on our summer holidays from school and obviously being with such iconic
Yeah.
people who had been in the first few seasons, and oh yeah, it was everything that you imagine it to be, it
Yeah.
was and more.
Was it filmed in like an actual like house or was it on a set?
Yeah.
Oh
No, it was in
wow.
a house up in Wales.
Oh wow. I always thought it was set when I was younger, and
No,
that's why
I
I'm
know,
always
it's
like,
always so really colourful, isn't it? But
yeah.
it was an actual house.
So of course, after Tracy Beaker, you starred in one of my all-time favorite TV shows in 2008. I remember seeing the teaser for Britannia High and getting really excited because it was around the time of High School Musical and that kind of thing
Yeah.
was just like really popular. So Seeing that, I was like, wow, this looks incredible. And also, we get to hear your vocals on the teaser for Watch This Space, which is one of the songs in Britannia High. I was 13 when that came out, and I was still in school, and it was the only thing that like made me really happy at the time. So I was being bullied at school for being gay. So this was like my
I'm
moment out.
sorry.
It's okay. It was like the only thing that was like really good in my life at that time, like watching, because I used to do dancing as well, dancing and singing. And it's what really got me into it more, watching you guys.
That's amazing, though. I
And
love that it inspired you so much.
yes, Lauren was my favorite character, I will say. I will have to say.
Thanks.
I kind of
Thanks.
felt like she was like the underdog of the show quite a
Yeah.
lot at the beginning. What was that? How did that happen, Britannia High?
So I got asked to audition, and I went to, it was quite a grueling audition process, actually, from what I remember. It was kind of like, it was about a week or two's worth of auditions kind of crammed into like a short space of time. It was like a boot camp. And they were really long days. And obviously we all got taken up to Manchester to audition. And there were obviously some amazing people up for it who didn't get Britannia High, who are now amazing. And just like have the career of dreams. Yeah, it was intense. I remember that much. It was very intense. And by the end of the audition process, we were exhausted. And it was Matthew and I that got cast from that process.
Wow.
So we were like the first
Yeah.
to get cast. And then I don't know if if you've seen, actually, there was a documentary that came out kind of alongside the series, and quite a lot of the audition process is on that. It was when they called my name out, I was shocked.
I remember watching the documentary on the DVD, which I do have. I've got
Amazing.
soundtracks as well. I've got the blue and the pink one, so you know. I
I love
found.
that so much. And I have to say, it was actually Sapphire who posted about Britannia High
Yeah.
now being available on Amazon Prime. And I was like, oh my goodness, this is just, it's crazy. I love so much that it's on there, because
Yeah.
obviously I go onto Spotify and I can't, find
Yeah.
the album, but it is on Apple Music. So, it's nice that
Yeah.
it's still out there somewhere in some shape and form. That's not just on a CD and DVD, because we've moved on
Yeah.
so much since 2008.
There was there was a TikTok that came up a while ago, and it was the performance of Best of Me from the show, and it said,
Way.
who remembers this? And I was like, oh my God. And I had like such a rush of nostalgia. And I was like, I remember watching this. I remember like begging my mom to play the soundtrack in the car. I remember like playing it like on full blast on my CD player and that kind of thing.
Oh, I love that.
And I was like, I need to watch this again because I love this. So I loved it when I was a kid. I really did. And I was like, I need to watch it. So I found it on Prime. And then obviously Sapphire posted it. I was like, yes, more people are knowing about this show. Because I think it was ahead of its time, personally, Britannia High. Because there
Yeah.
wasn't many dramas set in like performing arts schools with musical numbers. And well, there was High School Musical, but that was more of the American style of like drama schools and that kind of thing. But yeah, it was crazy. And when thinking of this show, I was like, who can I get on the first episode that's like really nostalgic towards to me? And I was like, oh right, I'll try and email like Georgina and see
Well,
if
I'm really glad you did.
she'll honestly, like we could talk about Britannia High all day. What was your favorite show from the song? Song from the show, sorry.
Ooh, my favorite song from the show. That's really hard, because I have so many. Having to pick one is tricky. I mean, it was one of mine, so of course I'm going to say it, but I think my favorite song was Best of Me.
Yeah, okay.
I had so much fun recording that song. And actually, a close second would be Picking Up the Pieces, I think.
I love that song. I think my all-time favourite one has to be Watch This Space.
Oh, I do love... I mean, how can I not say Watch This Space? But I think just for me, in terms of, like, remembering the experience on a whole for recording the album,
yeah,
I think Best of Me was... like my favorite for that.
Yeah.
And obviously, like, the writers, we had the most amazing experience where we got to go to like a writing boot camp with all of the songwriters.
Wasn't Gary Barlow and Guy Chambers there?
Yes,
They did most of the music, and Elliot Kennedy as well. He like
Elliot
did
Kennedy,
producing.
Guy Chambers, Chris Neal, Ina Rolston, who has strangely enough come back into my life recently.
Wow.
Because my husband is doing the international tour of Cats.
Oh,
and
wow.
She's playing Grisabella in Norway.
That's amazing.
I was like, this is crazy. Mark Owen, Gary, oh gosh, I'm going to not be able to remember his name now. And this is Gary. It's with an S. Can't remember. I'm going to have to look. One sec. I am going to have to look, because he had a single out of his own.
I thought it'd be on the soundtrack.
Is it not?
I don't think the credits are in the soundtrack.
That's not very good, is it? Oh no, we're credited. How am I going to find this out? Right, I'm going to have to Google. Tanya High songs. Maybe. List of Britannia High songs. Gary Go. About Begins with an S. Gary Go. Bring Christopher. He was another amazing songwriter. James Bourne from Busted.
Wow.
That was pretty cool. Who else? Just going, Steve Mack. Yeah, I mean, truly. Martin Sutton, who I adore. So many. Now looking at the list, it's actually crazy how many people there were.
I must say, on Best of Me, you are really giving vocals towards the end. Like the
Thanks.
Little ad libs.
You'll hear throughout the entire soundtrack there's points I'm just me wailing.
Yeah.
There's one in Picking Up the Pieces as well.
Yeah, there is.
Yeah.
It's kind of like that. Oh, yeah. That one.
Yes, you
like,
know it as well.
I don't know if you saw my, I did an Insta story of Britannia High just watching it all. And I got to Best of Me. And you can hear me singing your ad libs towards the end.
I love that.
So was there ever a series two planned? Because obviously there were like rumors of it being axed and ending abruptly.
I believe that they had hoped that there would be, but the cast are always the last to hear, so I don't actually know anything that happened.
Yeah. Oh.
Which is unfortunate, because I would have loved to have done a second season.
What do you think Lauren would have been doing in the second season? Because
I think,
ended with the live finale, really. It didn't really end with an
I think
actual
that she
story.
Would have been trying to navigate her life with her with her condition.
Yeah.
And also, I don't know. I mean, for me, obviously, I know that drama school is like a three-year thing. So it would have made sense to kind of get them at least to graduation, kind of like High School Musical, I guess, in a way. I don't know. It's a very good question, and I don't honestly know the answer. I don't know whether she would be with Danny.
The power couple.
Well, were they?
No.
Claudine and Danny were the power couple.
Yeah. Speaking of Claudine, I think she was really horrible to you I'm just gonna put it out there.
Yeah.
Like rewatching it now, as I'm older, I kind of understand the show a lot more now than I did back
Yeah.
then. So I'm watching it, I'm like, wow, Claudine, you are really like you're gaslighting Lauren here, sort
Oh
of.
yeah, but then they become best friends.
Yeah.
I mean, so it was, I think it obviously stemmed from a lot of jealousy.
Yeah.
But really, she's a teddy bear.
It's always the first episode opening credits that give me goosebumps, where you do the whole start of something,
Oh yeah.
and it's just the clip of you and Sapphire on the bridge doing
Yeah.
the routine, and then you see the people walking. I'm like, oh no, they're gonna get close. They're gonna have to stop in a minute.
I remember filming that song in blocks, kind of around London. Like, there's one point I'm dancing on a DLR train, and I get on the DLR to work every day
Yeah.
at the moment, and I'm like, oh gosh, Mems. Every day, I'm like, I probably swung around that pole at like 13 years ago, 14 years ago, whatever it was. Like, crazy. Crazy. The best thing was when filming the bit in front of the Covent Garden Plaza,
Yeah.
and literally just having like this crowd of people watching, not knowing what was going on, but
Yeah.
knowing something was going on. Yeah, that was incredible.
If you
Oh,
was
you're bringing back all the memes. I'm literally like, oh, this is incredible.
it's so nice that to hear you speaking in such positive light about it, because I know for a lot of people sometimes when they've done something in the past they don't really want to speak about it, they want to just focus on like what they're doing now kind of thing, but to hear you reminisce about it, to me it makes me really happy as well.
I loved it, and I so wish, I kind of wish actually that it was, you know, it happened in a time kind of a little bit where there was a bit more social media and
Yeah.
it's like in a more slightly kind of modern world.
Yeah.
Just because I do think that that would have had such a positive effect
Yeah.
on the series and its longevity. But yeah, no, I loved it. I honestly, I would have, well, I'd give a lot of things to be able to go back and revisit.
I think they should do like not like a soft reboot of Britannia High. And maybe have okay, in an ideal world, you're sat in like the ITV offices and they're pitching to you a new idea of Britannia High reboot. I think Lauren would be a teacher, a dance teacher, or maybe a singing
See you.
teacher.
Don't think she'd be a dance teacher. I mean, she really couldn't dance.
She got there. She got there in the end.
Eventually.
It's the scene where where Danny lifts you multiple times and you just fall that cracks me up.
That was, again, one of the funniest scenes to film. I was like, so this is really like an actor's playground of how many times can you fall? How many times can you make a fool look real? How many times can you make a fool funny? How many different ways can you fool? How many? It was brilliant, and I could have sworn I think I injured Mitch quite a lot filming that scene.
Oh, God.
Like a okay, we'll just gonna throw ourselves into it and see what
Literally.
happens. Yeah, literally.
Oh, this yeah,
Brilliant.
that I must admit when I watched it, I had to replay that scene over and over because I could not stop laughing. To the point my mum came in and was like, Jake, you all right? I was like, yeah, just look at this. And she's like, oh my God. And then just walks out.
I mean, to be fair, we were falling about laughing as well filming it. So our job was done.
Think one of my other favorite scenes as well, and I love just how you go into it, is Changing Man.
Oh, I love changing. See, that would have been one of my other favorite songs, actually. That was written by Bryn Christopher. I loved that song.
It's good. It's how you got it, just how you like go into it. The next minute, you're in the canteen, just like blasting it out. And
Yeah.
I think one of my favorite bits is between Markel and Matthew. And they're that close, you're just like, and they're like, okay. It's like, were they, weren't they?
No, they weren't. They weren't. I loved Jez and BB, like that, their relationship.
Yeah.
Yeah, gosh. so good. Like you say, very ahead of its time, actually.
Yeah.
Very ahead of its time. And that's why I do think, had it kind of happened, I mean, not necessarily now, but even 5 years ago, I think it would have been very different.
Yeah.
In a good way.
Yeah.
Like, in a positive way.
Yeah.
So
it tackled quite a lot of real life situations.
It did. And I think that
being like in a positive way, though, like not just drama, drama, drama. You'd have like the funny, the serious, the music to complement everything.
Yeah. And I do think that the writer's plan was for it to have always been slightly more dark and more serious, because obviously the time that it was on ITV, it was later. It wasn't necessarily pitched at children, or it was pitched more for young adults.
It did get put on CITV later on.
It did, and a lot of stuff got cut out.
Yeah, a lot.
But the plan was for it to have been to be even darker than it was originally.
God.
I know. Crazy, isn't it?
Yeah.
When you think about it. When you think about everything that happens with Bibi's brother and, you know, with Jez and
I know
Lauren's condition and an affair with a teacher, like.
I know. See, watching it back now, I understand it a lot more than I did, because back then I was just like, oh, this is like really grown up for me and I should be watching this.
Yeah.
Oh, there's a musical number. Okay, I'm fine.
Yeah, totally.
If you was asked to reprise your role as Lauren, would you?
Yes. No questions asked.
Good. Thank God. I'll start writing the script then.
Yeah, you do that. Give me a ring.
I was actually thinking the other day while watching it, I was like, I want to do, because being a big fan of Britannia High, I want to do like a little skit where I was like Lauren's cousin.
Oh my gosh, that would be amazing.
And I did a Zoom call.
From the New
and
Forest,
I'm like,
obviously.
You what, sorry?
From the New Forest.
Yeah. So
you need to come all the way down from the New Forest to visit Lauren in London.
And I'd be saying, what was that school you went to, Lauren? I can't remember. Oh, Britannia High. Oh, yeah, I've got in there. You what? What do you mean you've got in there? I was like, yeah, I've applied for an audition. I'm in there. And I was like, oh, there's a new teacher, though. I think it begins with a C. I forgot her name. About Claudine.
Yeah. Oh, my God, that would be amazing.
So I tried to get, like, I wrote a little bit of a script down saying, like Claudine was a teacher there and Mr. Nugent was still there and that kind of thing.
Oh,
But
Mr. Nugent.
I feel like not a lot of people would know what the show was. I mean, you'd have the niche sort of group of fans where they'd be loving it, and then you'd have the new generation like, what's this sort of thing?
Yeah, I have found, because at the time, I don't know that the fan base was as great as it maybe is now, or at least maybe not fan based, but actually I find more often than not now, and more people have seen it.
Yeah.
And I don't know whether it's from it being on CITV or whether it's from, I mean, I think it's only been uploaded to Amazon fairly recently. I don't think
I think around after the time it was on ITV, I think they put it on the ITV Hub on demand, and I think they took it down, and then it's only, I don't know how long it's been on Amazon Prime, but I know you do have to pay for it, which I don't mind anyway, but I've got the DVD, so
well, there you go. But I feel like even more people kind of in, you know, company members that I'm working with, or cast members that I'm working with a certain age, they all watched it. And it's so nice to hear that people, you know, that people did watch it.
Yeah.
So, I think if there was to ever to be a reboot or even a reunion, which would
that'd
be quite
be great.
Cause, I mean, gosh, the next big reunion would be 20 years.
Have you kept
which is
in
only
touch
in 6 years'
with
time.
The cast? Oh my God.
We have a WhatsApp group. You'll be happy to know.
That's amazing. Please tell me you've called it Britannia High.
What is it called? Reunion, I think.
Oh, wow.
I think the last person to write in it was a while ago, though. Maybe I'll just drop a message in right now whilst I'm on here. Reunion. There we go.
Wow.
January 2021. Sending love to all.
That's incredible.
There we go. But the picture is.
All of it. That's so cool. Oh.
Yeah. So we're still going strong 14 years later.
Wow. Okay, that's 13-year-old me is doing backflips as we speak right now and jumping for joy.
It's actually been really lovely. I think the only person that I actually haven't seen properly in the flesh since, well, pretty much since we finished, is probably Mitch.
Yeah.
Purely because, he's busy and
Yeah.
but yeah, I went to LA and saw Rana and Matthew.
Wow.
And I've seen Markel in and around London and then met up and went for drinks with kind of with Saf and Rana. Yeah, it's great. We're still very much in each other's lives, which
Oh, that's
is
good.
amazing.
Yeah. I think what could possibly be a thing is with the reunion, if you do like little blogs like you used to online after each episode, that'd be like really cool to see what the cast are up to now and
Gosh, I mean, everyone's been so successful since.
yeah.
A couple of parents, few parents in the group now, actually, half of us
Wow.
are parents. Got, Rana, Mitch, and Markel, who have all got babies.
Oh.
Yes, it's amazing, and this is why I'd love so much to do a reunion, I think, is just to
Yeah.
really just for everyone to be in the same room at the same time and be able
Yeah.
to just fill everyone in.
You could do a live tour, a one-off concert somewhere
I
where you do the
mean,
songs, that'd be.
I would love to. We need to get on the blower to Gary Barlow and be like, so you want to incorporate some Britannia High into your live tour? Could
You
you
could
imagine?
for the 20th anniversary, I think a one-off concert at the Albert Hall, like Britannia High Live in concert, would be incredible to see. You'd have all the music, like the clips on screen, and you'd be like just on the stage singing the songs together. And
Yeah, I would love that. I would love that so much.
we need to campaign it. We really do.
We'll get going. So after this interview on Instagram, we will start the campaign.
Yes. So, since Britannia High, you've been quite a busy bee, as we mentioned earlier on. You starred in Starlight Express and Heathers on stage. Is that a different experience to being on screen?
Yes, for many reasons. There is obviously with stage, it's live,
Yeah.
everything's live. So, actually, the closest experience would be doing the live finale of Britannia High, which was very much live, and scary because everything was timed out to an absolute T.
Yeah.
And obviously, the risk is with live theatre is things can go wrong, mistakes can happen. Whereas if you make a mistake with TV, you can go back and do it all over again. So, yeah, the answer is very different.
Because you've recently just starred as Mary Browning, but I'm a cheerleader of the musical at the Turbine Theatre. Have you seen the movie before? Did you know
I
what
have.
it was? Oh, okay, that's good.
Yeah, I loved it actually. When I was kind of in my early teens was when it came out and didn't really fully understand all of the nuances and really what
Yeah.
was happening. I just loved it because it was, very pink and had some actors in it that I liked and yeah, and had RuPaul in it.
Yeah.
So I was like, well, this is, and the woman from Casper. I was like, great, winning. But actually getting to revisit the story, well, say revisit, actually getting to portray Mary Brown and put the story across to an audience every night is really special. It's it I can't even begin to describe my love for the show, because the Turbine Theatre is such an intimate space. It's so incredible to see the audience reaction up close.
Yeah.
And it's a show that celebrates, you know, so much love and queer joy.
Yeah.
And getting to receive the love from the audience. And,
yeah,
you know, I've had so many people come up to me and say how grateful they are that this
oh.
show is happening, because, you know, of how they've felt, or with their journey, or whether they've been battling with their sexuality. It's been amazing. It's been such an eye-opening experience.
Yeah, because you've worked with Noel Sullivan as well from Hearsay, which is another one of my childhood greats. Like, that's, I'm quite jealous actually.
He's one of mine as well. I made that very clear on day one when I quoted all of Hearsay's, pretty much their entire album to him, and he was like, okay. Who are you?
Oh, it's quite like a full circle moment for you almost, because like, I bet, like, listening to Hearsay growing up and then getting to work with one of them is like,
yeah, it was. I mean, I love him. He's amazing. He plays kind of my counterpart in But I'm a Cheerleader. So we get to work very closely with him. And it just so happens that he's just, you know, one of the most amazing people that I've ever met and ever had the pleasure of working with. And I hope very much that we will stay in contact after this contract, because, yeah, he's a special one. He's a really, really good egg.
So, Miss Georgina Hagen,
Yes.
I have a little game for you now.
Okay, I'm scared.
So we've got some, I've found some lyrics from Britannia High songs. So I'm going to say some lyrics and I want you to finish them off.
Okay.
There's three lyrics to do, and then we've got a bonus trivia round.
Okay. Oh, gosh.
So, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Okay, so here's the first lyrics. So it is, and for a moment I was lost, and in a moment I was found again. Finish the lyrics.
And we all have second chances, and we all will make mistakes, because we're picking up the pieces. We're
Yes.
picking up the pieces.
Yes.
Really hard. Okay, I thought you were going to go easy on me and give me at least something that I'd like would know very well. Yeah, okay. I'm on a roll.
So that was from the song Picking Up the Pieces, which is another one of my favourites. It's quite, that is very uplifting as well, the lyrics as well.
Yeah, it's amazing. That was another song that was written by Ina and Mark Owen.
Wow.
Great song. That experience in the studio was one is the best.
Okay, so lyrics two. I hope you get this one. If I ask for advice, say look the other way. The things that really hurt are the things they don't say. I don't want to feel this anymore.
I don't want to be here anymore. Is it? It's a roller coaster ride, not a merry-go-round. Ain't a lot of ups, but I've seen a lot of downs. Is that one?
Yep.
Is it that verse?
Yep. And then it finishes with, I'm not going to take this
I'm
anymore.
Not going to take this anymore. Oh, men's.
13 years later, and she still sounds exactly the same. How is that possible?
Do I? Oh, gosh.
I literally
Brilliant.
got goosebumps then. I was like, oh, my God.
Oh,
So that was from
thanks.
The song Best of Me from Britannia High again. Wow, that's really took me back, that. Listen, hearing you. Wow. So this is the third and final lyrics, then we're on to the
Okay.
trivia round. Are you ready?
I am.
There is no shortcut to a dream, but I am not afraid. I'll take it all the way. Finish the
I'm
lyrics.
gonna give more than it takes, work harder than the rest, so I'm the very best. Oh, you think you got it all figured out?
Yeah, you got that right.
Yay! That was amazing.
That was from Watch This Space from Britannia High. And again, goosebumps hearing you sing that. That's took me back straight back again. So thank you. Thank you
You're
for that
welcome.
little live performance. Okay, so you actually got all three lyrics correct, so well done.
Thanks. I'm
Now,
sweating.
same.
I was like, oh God, if I get these wrong. Oh,
So
anyway.
we're going to move on to the trivia round now. This one might be a bit more difficult because it's like little things I've picked out from certain episodes.
Okay.
So the first question is, what tribute band was Lauren a part of, and who did she portray, sorry, in the tribute band?
So it was an ABBA tribute band, and she played Agnetha.
What was the name of the tribute band?
My gosh, I'm trying to go through like my opening speech. I'm going to say something really simple like Dancing Queens, but I don't know that that's
That's
right.
correct. That's right. And then you do your little Agnetha impression at the end, and everybody's
Thank
just
you
like.
very much. Yeah, okay.
Okay, so that was right. So, question two. At the end of episode two, Behind the Mask, what did the slogan say on their shirts while Danny is in the taxi? So, it's said quite often in the episode.
Yeah. I'll have what you're having.
Nope. I'll give you a hint. It was something to do with his assignment that he got you to do. He was doing something while you was also doing something for him.
I'll speak you right or something.
I'll give you that one. It was you talk, I type.
You talk, I type.
I'll give you that
Thanks.
one.
I'm
Okay.
going back 14 years, like,
I know.
and I actually haven't watched it since, so
Wow.
I'm going purely on memory.
Okay, so this is the third question. What does Lauren say to Claudine near to the end of episode one? So they're in the backstage. Claudine says something, and you instantly just snap and walk out. And everybody's like, oh, wow, okay.
Oh, it's not Get Lost, Claudine, is it?
So similar, yeah.
Oh, I can see it. No, I can't remember.
It was Drop Dead Claudine.
Drop dead, Claudine. I remember now.
I'll give you half a point for
Thank you. That's really kind.
that
I mean, Get Lost and Drop Dead are two very different things, but
one. It's just the way you just sat there and Claudine says something, you're like, Drop Dead Claudine, walk out. I'm like, oh, okay.
she angry.
She wasn't taking it no more.
No, she wasn't. That's before that routine, isn't it? Where
Yeah.
she does the lift. Yeah, I remember. And then she collapses.
And it makes life hard. Claudia was like, I didn't want her to die. It's like, well, you should have said it in the first place.
Yeah,
Like,
exactly. Exactly.
seriously, if you want to be a bitch about it, then be a bitch, but don't cause Lauren to collapse.
Well, I still am like, did the collapse happen because of what later comes out?
Yeah.
Was it just exhaustion?
I would put it down to exhaustion just purely because it was the very first episode
Yeah.
and we were introduced to the characters and we always see the montage of you jogging and
Must lose
rehearsing.
weight.
Yeah. And there was nothing on you, so there was no reason to.
Oh, to be that size again.
Okay, so are you ready for the final question?
Oh gosh, yes, I am, yes.
What was Lauren's full name?
Lauren Louisa Loretta Waters.
Yes. Yes. What does she say after that?
Big it up for the letter L.
Oh, thank God. I've got it written down here in brackets of you.
That much I remember. I got
okay.
that right.
So apart from the half point, you've got them all right. So well done. I'm
Thank
impressed.
You. That was so much fun. That was so much fun.
And I got to have a little impromptu performance by you, which was a bonus.
There you go.
Okay, so my final question. This isn't a trivia question, by the way.
Okay. I was like, oh my gosh, there's more.
Have you got anything planned for the future?
I have lots planned for the future. I have things that I can't speak about just yet because they're not announced. But yeah, hopefully just to do more of what I'm doing. I'd love to go back into telly. But that, I mean, in this day and age is way harder than just saying I want to go back into telly and expect to go back into telly. But yeah, I have lots, you know, lots coming up. This next year is going to be really exciting. And we shall see what the future holds.
Is there a Britannia High reunion on the cards then?
Oh, I'm going to try and make it happen. You have my word. You have my word. I've messaged the group. No one's replied. So, in fact, no one's even seen it yet. So, you know, but they're all in different time zones. So I'm not, that's one of the hardest things actually, is the fact that so many of them are over in the States or, yeah.
So if you were ever do a reunion and want a host, I'm available. So, you know.
Well, there you go. We already know, we have our host. So we need to make it happen.
Even if it was like a Zoom reunion, that'd be incredible.
Yeah.
I think I'd spontaneously combust by the sight of seeing all six of you from like childhood.
I think
so.
I would too, given that I've not seen everyone in one go for 14 years. But yeah, no, I would love that so much.
Do you still have any scripts or any props from Britannia High?
I have so much. I have so much memorabilia. I have, bless my mum and my nan, went out and got all of the merch that was sold in, I think it was in Asda's, like, at the time. I have, like, our original, like, media pack that we were given. I still have parts of Lauren's costume I was able to, like, take away. I don't know if you remember it from the live finale. It's like a stripy t-shirt with pink lips on and then a green shirt that I wore for Start of Me with the black blazer and a hat.
I can remember that one, yeah.
Yeah, I've got that.
Do you still have the white dress from Watch This Space?
I don't, because that white dress had to change for the finale and I can't remember why.
I think, hang on. I think it was because the lights would shine through the costume. You could see everything. Said like a last minute like thing to say like we need to change the dress now.
It was different. I think my shoes were different as well. I think the whole outfit was different. One thing I really wanted but couldn't get were the shoes that I wore for the Best of Me Live finale and that outfit with the bow blouse.
Yeah,
I loved that. Oh gosh, now I'm going down like outfit memory lane. It's great. I loved all my outfits in that show. Like, the styling was spot on.
Yeah,
I think for each individual. I loved it. I'll never forget when we kind of went and had our like initial makeovers, and they cut my hair off and dyed it kind of red and. I'm getting a phone call. Sorry, it's on my lap buzzing. It was great.
Oh, well, Georgina, thank you so, so much for joining me on the first episode of Back to Nostalgia. It's
thank
been an
you for
absolute
having
honor.
me. It's
I'm
been an
really
absolute
glad you're
joy.
Here.
It's been so lovely to sit and reminisce.
If you'd like to follow Georgina on social media, I will post her links below in the description. And if you want to follow me, that's fine. You can do. And you can subscribe to my channel when I upload the next episode. So thank you again, Georgina.
Thank you so much.
And I will see everyone on the next episode. Bye.
Bye.